Hey, how you doing, man? What's your name?
Alder Bruin.
Good to see you.
First of all, I actually wanted to thank you for coming out here. Trying to get some information with us.
Speak loud out into the mic so everybody can hear you, okay? Yeah, there you go.
It's on. I actually want to thank you for the part that you're playing in educating a lot of us for the obviously most abortion and prevalent issues here in the country. But you, as speaker, for everything that you do, obviously face criticism in the past. Don Lemon called you Rachel Dolezal 2.0.
Yeah.
There's some information that came out which had stated some, which had showed birth certificate and police records stating you as a white man. What do you have to say to the people who accuse you, attempt to discredit you and your work, and label you as a con man lying about your race and profit and publicity? And how do you, in your position, fight against that to continue the work that you're doing?
Cool. Well, it's a question that I've actually answered at great length, so I don't know if you've read what I've written and said and spoken about it. So you did the opposition research, but didn't actually read anything I said or done? Who sent you that?
This is just research I was doing this morning.
Say it again?
Research I was doing this morning.
For what purpose? I'm just curious. I'm not attacking.
No. When I found out you were coming, I just wanted to know things that people were saying against you, because obviously I'm a lot of issues on your side. I've read a lot about the things that you're doing. I wanted to hear about what your opponents have to say about you.
Do you believe that's true, that I'm Rachel Dolezal 2.0? Do you believe that?
I said.
No, I'm asking you. I'm saying we're having a conversation.
No. I wanna assume that you are who you say you are.
Who do I say that?
Shaun King.
Of course I'm Shaun King. I'm saying I just wanna understand. I wanna get to the root of it. Like let me break it down. In 2015, a guy named Milo, who was at the time working for Breitbart, who had for 3 months told a series of lies about me. First, Milo said that I was lying about how many children I had, which is a peculiar lie, and it never picked up. Then I had multiple spinal surgeries from an assault that I had. I was 15 years old. And then Milo and others said he was never, like, I have scars up and down my back from any people. Like, I wasn't like a mystery man in another place. People were there with me through the surgeries. I had two when I was in high school, another when I was in college. And he said I fictionalized the entire thing. Nobody believed it, and it went on. Then the lie was, I am raising money for the Black Lives Matter movement, and I'm keeping the money for myself. Then we released all the financial records, showing that I've always had multiple jobs, that I never kept a dime, not even a dime, not a penny. I never received, not only that, but that none of the money was ever even in my possession. That families we raised money for received 100% of what we raised. But the lie went away. After those lies, Rachel Dolezal happened. She's a crazy woman, right? Like she sued Howard University for discriminating against her as a white woman. Howard University is a black college, and she sued the black college because she said they discriminated against her as a white woman. Then she moved across the country and began living her life as a black woman. And then a random reporter who just knew her and knew her parents asked her, and she like had nothing. She had nothing. In the midst of that, it was a juicy thing for people to say, is there someone else among us who could be white? Do me a favor. You have a phone? Somebody, let's just do this as an illustration. Somebody Google my name real quick and go to my Wikipedia page. Go to my Wikipedia page. Just bear with me for a moment. My first name is spelled with a U, S-H-A-U-N. Come over here real quick.
No.
No, let me just. Let's go to the Wikipedia page. Early life. King grew up in Versailles, Kentucky. Did you go to this page? Did you go to Breitbart to get this information? Where did you get it? Okay, here's what it says. Shaun was raised by his white mother and white adoptive father. It says, according to a local police detective, those who knew him were aware of his biracial heritage. Here's a quote from that police officer. Anyone from around here who knew him knew he was mixed. Okay? All right. Go back to the mic for a second. So, in 1995, I was assaulted. And on the police report, there was not a box for mixed. There was a black box and a white box. And the officer checked the white box. That officer then says, he knew I was mixed, and everyone in the town knew I was mixed. People in the town know who my biological father is. And people now, 22 years later, are trying to use the fact that when I was assaulted, they say never happened. When I was assaulted, that he checked the box, which he said he only checked because there wasn't an option. And he even told me, he said, in the moment, Shaun, had I known 22 years ago that people would have said this is a lie, that I would have checked black and white. And so what people did, Oliver, what people did was try to find something to discredit me. Because I've always been who I am. Like, there's not a single human being on earth who will ever say, I remember when Shaun used to say he was white. Not when I was in elementary school, not when I was in middle school. Listen, they interviewed my mother. Like, I literally had, if you read my piece, I had to write an article saying who my mother had sex with. Do you want to know who my mother had sex with in 1979? Is that what we're getting to? No, no. Because at the root of it, what you want to know is who Kay King had sex with in 1979. And what I'm trying to communicate to you is, had you spent a little more time doing your research, you would have found more about, since you want to know who my mother had sex with, I talked at great length about who she had sex with, at great personal embarrassment to me and her, so that when a guy like you was curious, you could know. Because you like knowing who old ladies had sex with in the 70s. Right?
What do you have to say to those who accuse and attempt to discredit you for your work based on?
But see, Oliver, I've already answered this at great length. That's what we're talking about. It is when, no, at the root of is he black or not, is who Kay King had sex with in the 70s. Do you know who your mother had sex with? All of them? I'm just curious. Is that the conversation we're having right now? It's a weird conversation, right? It's awkward, right? It's a little awkward. All right.
Thank you.
Who? I'm saying, it was an awkward question, awkward conversation. I'm always willing to lean right into the awkward.